My name's Patrick Windham from the United States. And I'm a former U.S. Senate staffer and more recently a teacher and consultant. In the U.S., it's sometimes hard to talk about innovation and employment. First, as been discussed here, those two fields done by very different groups of people, different government agencies. We also have a debate in the United States about the role of government. Our Republican friends want to minimize that. Their view is that employment policies, including things like the minimum wage, hurt innovation. So part of the discussion needs to be about what kinds of policies actually help and which don't, and try to get evidence on those questions. There's a great debate in our country about whether innovations are currently creating many jobs or not. One of the things I talked about today are some studies that suggest that we don't have recent innovations that are creating large amounts of jobs, such as the internal combustion engine creating the automobile industry, leading to aircraft, et cetera, or electricity. We don't see many of those big new job-creating innovations at the moment. And the one we have, which is computerization and information technology generally, seems at the moment to be destroying more jobs than it's creating. So one question is, are there investments we can make in Europe or the United States or Asia that might create new innovations that could create new waves of job creation? In terms of the new kinds of jobs that will come out of innovations are in the computer field. And while many traditional, more routine jobs are being destroyed, we're getting all sorts of new jobs with people that can either program computers or know how to use them, Google being an example, or Facebook. Some of the new innovations that might come out are things like synthetic biology, new developments in healthcare, and so forth. But it's a little early to know how many jobs might come out of some of these other areas. I think historically in the United States, investments in areas such as the internet, aircraft, and other areas have led to huge new industries and job creation. And some of us would like to continue to see those kinds of investments made in both university research and in engineering projects such as the internet.